Not drinking. That is without doubt the ultimate way to avoid a hangover. You're welcome. Don't get smashed, but do smash that subscribe button. All right, for real though, for those of us who are going to drink anyway, or for those of you watching who may already be hungover, let's talk about what we can do to improve your morning after state. Because there are tons of hangover cures that are touted as being the true winners, from drinking tons of water to eating greasy eggs, accidentally in the shape of a devil there. Deviled eggs. But do any of them actually have any scientific backing? Well, that all depends on what actually causes a hangover. And perhaps surprisingly, that's a topic that there's still a lot of debate about to this very day. But we all know what causes hangover symptoms, right? It's dehydration, surely. Your dry mouth and headache can be blamed on the fact that alcohol makes you pee more, and so you pee out all the water you did have, you're not taking in much more water. Voila, dehydration station. Hand in hand with dehydration comes electrolyte imbalances. And electrolytes are just substances that are found in the fluids of your body, and they're important for making you work properly. Well, I went into this video thinking that dehydration and electrolyte imbalances were what caused a hangover. I was dead set on it, but there's actually quite a lot of evidence to suggest otherwise. There have been scientific studies which have taken people with hangovers and measured their, not like taken them as in stolen them, like investigated, volunteered. There are scientific studies which have looked at people with hangovers and measured their electrolyte levels and their body water content. And those studies found that those values were no different to normal. Therefore, that suggests that the symptoms you feel the next day don't come from dehydration, but are caused by something else. And whilst we pee a lot when we're drinking, especially if you've broken the seal, am I right? It doesn't actually lead to excessive water loss. That's what these scientists say anyway. They say that rather you're taking in more liquid and peeing it out quicker, so it's essentially just passing through you quite quickly. So you kind of perceive that you're dehydrated rather than you actually being that dehydrated. This took a bit for me to get my head around, right? Especially because my desert of a mouth the morning after has other thoughts on the matter. But it is still a topic that's up for debate. That's what's interesting about it. There are some scientists who think that dehydration is an important part of hangovers, and there are others who say it is kind of irrelevant. But if the theory that dehydration isn't that important is true, then it suggests that drinking tons of water or bottles of Lucozade, other electrolyte balancing drinks available, the morning after may not be the best route to freshness. That being said, drinking water on the night out itself can still be helpful in reducing your hangover symptoms the next day, if only because whilst you're drinking water, you're not drinking alcohol, so you end up drinking less alcohol. Right? Whether it's a factor in your hangover or not, it's kind of generally agreed that dehydration can't be to blame for all of the potential hangover symptoms you could experience, because there's a lot of them. So what else could be to blame? Well, there are two prominent theories that seem to have emerged as the front runners. The first is that a lot of the issues are caused by a chemical that's produced when alcohol is broken down. You see, alcohol is broken down in the body into a substance called acetaldehyde. Science hangover fuel, acetaldehyde. Acetaldehyde is a known carcinogen. In other words, it increases the risk of developing cancer. It mainly ends up gathering in the liver, and so it makes sense that excessive drinking leads to an increased risk of liver cancer. It's actually also released in cigarette smoke, but that is a whole other topic. Whilst it's dangerous, acetaldehyde is short-lived, eventually getting broken down further into less harmful substances. However, your body has a limit to how quickly it can do this. And so, the more alcohol you drink, the greater the backlog of alcohol that needs to be turned into acetaldehyde, and the greater the backlog of acetaldehyde that needs to then be broken down into those less harmful substances. As we get older, we get less efficient at this kind of breaking down chain, which may be a surprise to hear. You're worse at breaking down as you get older. And that can help to explain why hangovers get worse as you age. I can still remember that first morning that I woke up after a night of drinking, where I'd previously never really had hangovers before, and suddenly I had like a headache and a queasy, unsettled feeling, and it dawned on me that I was now in the hangover twilight of my life, and it was only downhill from there.
Surprise, I'm here forever.
Oh no. Also, each of these breakdown processes is controlled by an enzyme, and these enzymes come in different types. It's thought that the type of enzyme you have affects how you experience hangovers. For example, a version of the enzyme that converts alcohol to acetaldehyde faster than others is particularly common in people of East Asian descent. Because it's working faster, it leads to the acetaldehyde building up quicker and causes something colloquially known as Asian flush, which is where people go bright red and start feeling quite nauseous and unwell after drinking relatively small amounts of alcohol. So it seems pretty likely that the majority of our hangover symptoms are caused by this pesky chemical acetaldehyde. What can we do about it? Well, we have three main options really. One, end up with less acetaldehyde in our bodies to start with, aka drink less alcohol. Two, speed up how quickly the breakdown of acetaldehyde into less harmful things happens. Or three, combine acetaldehyde with something else to make it less toxic. Surprisingly, there's one popular hangover cure that could help with that third option. Ladies and gentlemen, it's the fry-up. It's the fry-up, ladies and gentlemen, it's the fry-up. Eating food before drinking is indeed important for lining your stomach and slowing the absorption of alcohol. But there's actually some evidence that eating certain foods the day after may help you too. There's a substance in your body called cysteine, and that reacts with acetaldehyde to produce something that's less harmful. So the theory goes that if you eat foods that contain lots of cysteine, it may help to reduce your hangover symptoms. And such foods include eggs, I've eaten the one from before, but picture I have one, eggs, which are a staple part of any fry up, and also bacon, here is, for you meat eaters out there. So if you can stomach a bacon butty, which to be honest is kind of a challenge in itself when you're hungover, then it might do you some good. Saying that, this is kind of two theories stitched together, right? We know that cysteine reacts with acetaldehyde to make it something less harmful, and we know that there are some foods that contain lots of cysteine, but I haven't actually seen any evidence yet that connects the two, that shows that eating foods that are high in cysteine will actually reduce your hangover symptoms. Still, it's a good excuse for a full English, isn't it? If your body is a temple and you want to avoid grease, or your body isn't a temple and you want to avoid grease anyway, there are some other foods that might be able to help you out too. In particular, extracts from various different fruits, roots, and leaves. There was a scientific experiment that was published just this year that boldly called itself probably the world's largest study investigating how food extracts can help with hangovers. For the first paragraph at least, they actually used the official scientific term for hangover, which if you're wondering is visalgia, and that comes from the Norwegian word kveis, hope I'm pronouncing that right, which apparently means uneasiness following debauchery. That's so great. If there's any Norwegians watching who can't confirm that, I'll appreciate it very much. Don't want to be making a low-key idiot of myself on the internet. Too late for that. Anywho, in this study, they got a bunch of people drunk in a constantly illuminated room, woo, party, and then gave them like a cure drink that contained extracts from lots of different plants that it was thought would help reduce their hangover symptoms for various different reasons. So for example, it contained extracts from fenugreek and mango because those are thought to increase the speed at which the enzymes break down acetaldehyde. It turned out that the people who had the vegetation concoction had significantly less severe headaches, feelings of nausea, and feelings of restlessness compared to people who had nothing, a placebo, and those who had like a concoction of vitamins and minerals. Although with the plant drink, they kind of just like threw everything in it that might work, so we don't know what specifically was having the beneficial effect. It could have been the fenugreek carrying the whole thing on its little green back, or it could have been like positive effects from everything together. We're not quite sure, but still, it's a pretty interesting finding. I mentioned before that there are two prominent theories as to what causes hangover symptoms, and the other one is that your immune system is to blame via the process of inflammation. Science hangover cause inflammation. Inflammation is your body's response to being injured, basically. I've actually talked in a previous video about how your immune system links to stress, so you can check that out if you want after, but for now, I'm just going to say that it's thought that inflammation triggered by your immune system could help to explain some of the hangover symptoms like concentration issues and memory problems. Cytokines communicate with your brain, and it's thought that high levels of them could start to interfere with memory formation. If inflammation does have a role to play in your hangover, then a treatment may be as simple as keeping a couple of pills by your pillow, aka ibuprofen pills that you take before bed, because ibuprofen is an anti-inflammatory, reduces inflammation, and that could reduce your hangover symptoms. Or to go back to our plants from earlier, it's thought that extracts from the prickly pear plant could reduce hangover symptoms by blocking the release of inflammatory chemicals in your body. No wonder Baloo's always so chill.
Now when you pick a pawpaw or a prickly pear.
Saying all this though, a hangover has lots of constituent parts, right? In this video alone, I've pointed out that the things that cause memory and concentration issues are probably different to the things that cause the physical grim feelings. I've even made a whole separate video about anxiety and how that's caused by neurochemical changes in your brain. By the way, that video prompted a lot of people in the comments to be like, Sophie, are you okay? Just checking in. Are you all right? Yeah, I was okay. Don't worry. I was fine. I am fine. It is chill. It was just that I was kind of, that was my final year of being a student. And so I kind of gave it my all and made it a year of wildness. I'm older and wiser now and the pubs are shut. So it's all good. Anyway, what I'm primarily saying is that it makes sense that there might be lots of different causes of what we see as a hangover, with each aspect bringing its own special brand of nastiness to the table, like a Jacob's join of disgust. So that might mean that we need lots of different hangover cures to kind of treat each aspect. It's safe to say that hangover research, much like your hangover head, is still a little bit fuzzy. And whilst during my research, I found various values given to the economic cost of hangovers due to unproductive working hours and stuff like that, there still doesn't seem to be many labs working on a way to freshen up the morning after. But one scientist who has investigated a way to reduce the impact of hangovers is Professor David Nutt. I'd actually heard of David before researching for this video because of his work on psychedelic drugs and their potential place in treating depression. But whilst he feels that drugs like MDMA, psilocybin, which is found in magic mushrooms, and LSD have been unfairly vilified and their potential benefits when carefully controlled completely ignored, on the flip side, he believes that alcohol has been seen as way too innocent and it has far too few controls on it. Those views are basically what got him fired as one of the British government's top drug policy advisors. He's a really interesting guy with lots of interesting ideas and lots of interesting research, but for now I'm just going to mention one of his kind of projects. That project is that he wants to see if he can produce synthetic alcohol. Namely, he's trying to produce substances that will give you the buzz of alcohol, but won't have any of the negative effects, or that have an antidote that you can take that will prevent you from getting any of the negative effects. In 2014, he said he had 5 chemical compounds that looked like good options, and then in 2018, he applied for a patent for a series of alcohol-mimicking chemicals, which were branded as Alkarel. However, since then, it seems that publicly shared research on them has kind of dried up a little, so I'm not sure what's happening there. So until David Nutt has his way, it looks like the best options for a hangover cure are prickly pears, eggs, and good genetics. And if you really want to be safe, not drinking. That's it for now though, everybody. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Do please leave a comment about what hangover cures work for you. Is there anything I've not mentioned in this that you are certain works? Do tell me so I can give them a try. Like this video if you like it, share it if you share it, subscribe to me if you want to subscribe to me, and media my socials if you want to do that too. Otherwise, all that's left to say is thank you so much for watching, have a lovely day, and remember,
I'll see you in the morning.
And a huge thank you to my patrons, with a special end of 2020 shout out to Brent Knudsen, Terry Cox, Justin Brown, and Adam Dollinger. Oh, that's intoxicating. We're eating greasy eggs. Oh, it's so oily. Mellow. I'm doing this before I've had a shower, so my hair's got a slight greasy hangover sheen. Extracts from fenugreek and mango. Mango.
Why? You're too straight now.
I am.
Never been my problem before.
My.
That's the end. Here's the video that made people ask me if I was okay. Here's a playlist of my favourites. And here's my Patreon. Bye!